Hello everyone, Cherries Red Army, and welcome to this latest match day vlog. I'm actually starting this recording the Friday night before because we're about to go live 8 o'clock on our YouTube channel for our live preview with Sean View and our Bournemouth guests. So make sure you join us for our previews if you haven't seen them before. Head over to Cherries Red Army, hit the subscribe button and don't miss them. Get involved because there's an interactive chat. This is going to be a massive game. We'll be leaving early Saturday morning to make the trip up north for that first early kickoff in the Championship. And it's going to be a big game for the Cherries. It's a must not lose fixture, so we say, because we are still in the driving seat. We still have some games in hand on certain teams. And we've just got to keep ticking over and getting the points, because I'm still convinced we'll be absolutely fine and we will get this job done. But this is a hard fixture. We don't have a great record at Bramall Lane. But hey, stuff like that's there to be broken. So sometimes luck has to turn and maybe it'll happen on Saturday. Make sure you subscribe, hit the like button, and at some point at the end of this video, get your comments in below. Let us know how you're feeling. But we'll join you Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon for the game. I've got to get on with the show, so we'll see you soon. Morning Cherries, so we are about 100 miles away from Sheffield United and Bramall Lane, due to be there about 9:30, so a nice early start. And it's a big game for us today. I expect to see changes at about 11:45. Maybe Gary Cahill will come back into the side, and I definitely want Todd Cantwell in the team. But what we do need to make sure is that we pick something up from the game. We want to play well, get some shots on target, and at least take a point away from this game, because that will put us in good stead going into those Easter fixtures. Let's see how the day pans out. Let's see if we can get some good reactions for you. Let's hope we're all smiling at the end of this football match. Make sure you put those comments at the end of this video and give it a like. So as we're heading up north for Sheffield United in the opposite direction, we've got a couple of Grimsby fans here in McDonald's breakfast. Steve and Dave, you're heading up to Weymouth.
Morning.
Or down, shall I say. How you doing?
Fine, thanks, yeah.
Tell us a bit about Grimsby Weymouth then. What are you looking for today?
Well, we're looking for a win, obviously. it is a banana skin, potentially. Weymouth played well at Grimsby, I thought, on the night. And maybe a little bit unlucky. But we're hoping to turn them over today, hopefully.
Yeah, we're sitting in seventh place, so we're just in the playoff spots. And we need 3 points, really, today to call us consolidate and stay in the playoffs and push on. That's what we're aiming for. So in the playoffs and take it from there.
A bit of history between Bournemouth and Grimsby. We've already spoken about that over breakfast. Have you got any thoughts on Bournemouth Sheffield United today? Big game in the Championship.
Well, it is a big game. It's a long way from where we are usually. But I would like Bournemouth to win. We've never had a lot of love for Sheffield United. But no.
I
think it'd be a good game.
I fancy a draw. Score draw for you lot today. I do. I'm a bit of a Eddie Howe fan, and I used to watch Bournemouth quite a bit when Eddie was there. I actually think Eddie could be a future England manager. I think he's that good now. I thought it was a big loss for the club, but I think you'll have a score draw today. Big crowd there, great atmosphere.
Yeah. Looking forward to it. That's what we've gone for on the channel as well. Have a good day out, guys. Down in Weymouth.
You too. Good luck.
Safe trip and good luck today.
Cheers.
Life is black and blue, happy then it's sad. Just call it an adventure, then it ain't so bad. Together we touch the sky. Wherever we go, we fly. Forever we know adventures in the air tonight.
Easy drive then to Bramall Lane, all parked up. Just gone 11:45. Lineups are out. Todd Cantwell sitting on the bench again. Don't get it. Don't understand it. Bring a player in like that. Build a squad in January that surely you're going to utilise in busy periods. But you continue to play Philip Billing for three consecutive games. Billing's got great numbers. You know I rate Billing nowadays, but it's okay to rest him. So it's one change in that team, then Bele for Anthony, the rest as you are. Get a result tonight, today, fair enough. You know, you get a win, no problem. But if you don't get a win, there will be questions asked why you've got the likes of Todd Cantwell sitting on the bench. Sat on the bench for 90 minutes against Bristol City, sat on the bench for most of the game against West Brom, starts on the bench when there's an opportunity to freshen it up. But let's see how we go. We'll back the boys, as we always do. We need to start well. First goal could be key. And we probably need to get that first goal because Sheffield United have a very, very strong home record. Kick off at 12:45 then. We'll see what the Cherries can do.
Travers!
Half time then at Bramall Lane, it's Sheffield United 0, Bournemouth 0. And you can thank Super Mark Traver’s for Bournemouth still being in this game. An unbelievable save he made at the end of that first half. But that one change is maybe tripping us up a bit at the moment, because for the first quarter of this game, we were struggling. We were not winning 50-50 battles. Smith was getting overrun. Smith looks like he needs an oxygen tank in this half-time break. Lloyd Kelly's almost put two in his own net. And we've struggled to really get going up top. There's been a few glimpses, a few moments. Christie's had a few shots. One straight down the keeper's throat. The other one over. Dom Solanke, we've been unable to get in areas that can hurt them. And Lerma has struggled to win 50-50 battles, and it's just not completely gelling. We're not really getting ourselves into a position to really hurt Sheffield United. But 0-0, we take a draw at the start of this game, but I think there will be goals in this game, so we're going to need to score. Todd Cantwell is sitting on the bench. He's a player we brought in. He could be a game changer if we want to get promoted. I don't understand why he's not in this game, why he's not playing. But let's see what Scott Parker does in the second half, because there's some players out there that are really struggling and we're going to need to do a little bit more. Now shooting towards us, the Bournemouth fans, and maybe that will help the team. Time outside Bramall Lane. You can vlog that there's clashes here. There's clashes of the vlog. Full time.
Cheers.
Sheffield United 0, Mark Traver’s 0.
start of the day, I said a draw would be a good point because we have got those games to come over Easter, which are better than the team we're meant to be worried about in Forest. But, because of Mark Traver’s, we got out of there with a point. I didn't get the starting lineup fully. I understand you can't make wholesale changes, but we've played three games in 8 days. Players were looking leggy against West Brom, but only one change today. Don't know where Ethan Laird is, bored of even bringing up the name. Jack Stacey, I'm not sure. Gary Cahill wasn't with the squad, so maybe that's an injury. So it was just Dembele in for Anthony. And the first half was pretty much Sheffield United's. We were okay in pockets, but they had the better chances and had an exceptionally good chance just for half time, which Mark Traver’s kept out because he's a brick wall nowadays. And he's added another clean sheet to his stats. Second half though, there was a spell, a very good spell, where we were on the front foot and we had a chance to take Sheffield United down. I thought there would be goals in this game. I thought it would be tight. But then there was a substitution from Scott Parker. He brought on Anthony for Dembele, like for like. But Todd Cantwell signs from Norwich, clearly wants to play football. Could be a game changer because of the talent he's shown previously, especially in this league. But he plays 0 minutes against Bristol City, comes on against West Brom when we're 2-0 down and has to find a magical pass through 10 players. And sits on the bench today for 90 minutes. Well, didn't get on the pitch. I have nothing against Philip Billing. I've got a lot of time for Philip Billing. His stats are very good this season, again. But I have no idea, and I'm very confused in why he continually stays on the pitch when he's been non-effective. And when the game is open at 0-0 at times, and you have got a player in Todd Cantwell that can have that clinical pass in the final third, why don't you try and utilise it? What I saw today in Scott Parker, a manager I backed, by the way, at the start of the season, very much Parker in and the process, was a manager that's good and probably will be good for the rest of his career. There's a difference between managers that are good and great, great managers. Roll the dice when they see an opening, or make a change that's not really going to unsettle your team, because Cantwell for Billing wouldn't have done that. It'd have given you fresh energy and a new creativity from a right foot instead of a left. But he didn't. He sticks to his guns. We nearly lost it at the end because Sheffield United couldn't hit the target. And I come out of this game happy that we got a point, because any point added to our total is going to help us get promoted, but slightly frustrated that there was 3 points available there today, and a player like Todd Cantwell is continually not getting a chance. So that's my feelings. Turn it round on a positive again for this vlog, that Mark Traver’s is absolutely fantastic, brilliant, and the reason we'll get promoted this season, if we do, is because of Dom Solanke and Mark Traver’s. I want to get your thoughts though. If you're at the game, listen to it on the radio, watch it on Sky Sports, what do you think? Maybe I'm talking tosh, but I'll tell you how it is, because that's how I roll. And going into an Easter period, we're going to need to pick up 6 out of 6, hopefully. 4 out of 6 might be enough, but we're definitely going to need to not lose those games either. Subscribe if you're new to Cherries Red Army. We hope you've enjoyed this match day vlog. There might not have been any goals, but it was an aggressive and exciting 0-0 draw to a point without Bournemouth getting the goalkeeper of Sheffield United dirty, shall we say. Hit the like button, that really does help. And I'll read every single comment that you drop down below. From Sheffield and Bramall Lane though, I'll confirm. Sheffield United 0, Mark Traver’s 0. Make sure you continue to watch the channel, because we'll have new content coming next week as we go back home to take on Middlesbrough. Enjoy the rest of your week. Look after yourself. See you soon. Up Cherries. Together we touch the sky, wherever we